really just living within your means, you know. I mean, she taught me to believe in myself, obviously, but the thing that she didn't really say, but she led with, by example, is that to always, you know, save a little bit of money and not have this big flashy lifestyle, and just really to know that when you feel comfortable financially, you make better decisions. Like the pressure of finances or running out of money actually makes you make, it actually paralyzes you to make decisions. I love that movie, Love Actually, and the sort of insights into people's lives and the way they just, the director has actually pulled it all together into one story. I love that sort of movie. Schindler's List is a big one for me though. I seem to be able to watch it over and over again. Yeah, they're probably the two. Breakfast this morning was, well actually I had two breakfasts this morning. So I had a chocolate protein shake before I trained. It was leg day. And I can still walk today, which is pretty good. Don't know how I'll feel tomorrow. And then when I got to work, I had a frittata with roasted pumpkin and sun-dried tomatoes and kale in it. It was delicious. Gosh, I mean, we all have to deal with those things. It's part of being human, I guess. And terrible things happen in your life. And the first thing you do is like, why did that happen to me? But I guess then the mechanism clicks in that you think, well, I have to cope with it. I have to, in some cases, move on from it. In other cases, I just have to do what I can. But pretty much, you just have to put one foot in front of the other and keep moving, you know? And then it's really quite crazy because you can look back in 6 or 12 months and think, that was such a big deal and so overwhelmingly hurtful, or I just didn't feel like I could get through that, and then you do. I mean, humans are so resilient, it's amazing. I wish we didn't have to go through that, but I think it also helps you appreciate the things that you have in your life. So yes, we all do that. We are not immune to it because we have a successful business, I guess. Oh, I guess I still doubt myself, you know, and I think that's a really important part of being human, and an important part of wanting to be the best is that you do constantly question yourself and want to make every decision a good one for your business and for the people that work for you and for your customers. I think doubt, as long as it doesn't get out of control, is really, really healthy. Yeah, I think you have to listen to your doubts, but also believe in yourself at the same time. So it's a bit of a game.